July 17, 1955. After 50 years of operation, it has become known for its vast assortment of amazing experiences, long lines, and creepy robots.
Wait.
When you visit the Magic Kingdom for the first time, you may feel overwhelmed, and like all you want to do is hide in Main Street Cinema and escape the endless lines of scary cartoon characters. This guide has been designed so that you may enjoy your trip. Joining me are Will, Sonia, Poilus, Alex, and me. Now let's get started.
In order to have gotten to this spot, you must have already traveled through five lines of doom. The line to get into the parking structure, the tram, the security line, the ticket lines, and finally the line to get into the park. Have fun!
The first thing you should always do is to get a park map and entertain yourself. The park guide will give you all the information necessary to have a great time.
There's just one more important thing you should know about before you go.
It's the Fast Pass!
That's right, Molly. If you want to avoid these pesky lines, you'll need to know about the Fast Pass.
How does it work?
Fast Pass is fairly simple. Just insert your park ticket into the machine. Then, a different Fast Pass ticket will come out the bottom. The ticket has a return time and a time where you can get another Fast Pass for dinner.
This is the Main Street train station. It is one of our four stops on the Disneyland Railroad. The other stops are located in New Orleans Square, Toontown, and Tomorrowland.
This is Main Street, USA. Walt Disney designed it to look like his hometown of Marshall. You can find shops, dining, and lots of candy.
This is Tomorrowland. It contains futuristic attractions and demonstrations, or at least it used to. Now most of that stuff has been pushed into innovations.
Tomorrowland has many exciting rides like Star Tours, Buzz Lightyear's Astro Blasters, Autopia, the Finding Nemo submarine voyage, and of course, Space Mountain. This is Adventureland. It's a land of lions, tigers, and tiki birds. Oh my! The oldest ride in this land is the world-famous Jungle Cruise.
If you ever get a chance to ride the Jungle Cruise, make fun of your skipper's hair. I dare you.
The most popular ride in Adventureland is definitely Indiana Jones. This ride uses advanced motion vehicles to make you feel like you are really backing up away from a giant boulder. This is a must-do.
If you're hungry, make sure to stop at by the Bengal Barbecue. Try the Zulu sauce. It's really good.
In the Enchanted Tiki Room, you'll see a show put on entirely by birds, tiki statues, and flowers. This was the first appearance of the groundbreaking audio animatronics.
Please note that this does not count as a creepy robot slash annoying song ride because it's just too awesome. The same rule applies for Winnie the Pooh, Mr. Toad's Wild Ride, and the Electrical Parade.
Frontierland is a place where you can explore a whole island or ride a wild mine train past to go with some serious dynamite. You can also get some serious turkey leg action.
If you're looking for a break, you should catch a ride on Columbia Sailing Ship or the Mark Twain Riverboat. It's a chance to relax and enjoy the calming motion of the rivers of America.
Big Thunder Mountain Railroad opened in 1979 on the site of the old Living Desert. The Living Desert contained many classic attractions. The current mountain is based on the real-life Bryce Canyon.
New Orleans Square opened in 1966 and is based on 19th century New Orleans. This land contains many shops and dining locations, including the Blue Bayou Restaurant. The indoor dining room overlooks the area of Pirates of the Caribbean and offers delectable dishes such as Alaskan King Crab.
One of Disneyland's many secrets can be found here at 33 Royal Street. Behind this door is a secret members-only club called Club 33. The waiting list for the club is several years long, and membership costs thousands of dollars. And don't bother knocking on the door. It doesn't work.
This foot mortal is the Haunted Mansion. It opened in 1969, though it sat here in Orleans Square for many cold, lonely years before it finally opened. The Haunted Mansion is known for its outstanding special effects and, of course, the ghost host. It almost never has a long line, and it is impossible to see all of its surprises for the first time through, so you'll have to go again.
Critter Country opened in 1989 and was formerly home to the world-famous original Country Bear Jamboree, even though the original attraction opened and is still operating in Florida. The building that is used to contain the Country Bear Playhouse is now owned by a different bear.
Disneyland's major water ride can be found in Critter County. Splash Mountain is based on the 1946 Disney movie Song of the South. It tells the story of Br'er Rabbit and his realization that there's no place like home. Many of the songs from the film are used in the ride, such as Zippity Doo Dah.
The log ride Splash Mountain has a drop at 47 degrees, and it reaches 5 stories. The log can go at least 40 miles per hour. Mickey's Toontown is the newest Magic Kingdom land. It's styled to look like the cartoon world. There are many interactive gags scattered throughout the land. Toontown is also contains the houses of Mickey and Minnie Mouse. Disneyland's most well-known land is Fantasyland. It's a place where anything is possible. It is also home to Disneyland's most memorable rides, Snow White, Pinocchio, Peter Pan, Alice in Wonderland, and Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. Though they may appear to be for young children, you may find surprises on them. It's a Small World started in the 64-65 New York World's Fair. It was later moved here. In 2008, the ride was closed for refurbishments for almost a year. They added a controversial America Room and something else I can't remember.
It's a Small World. Close your eyes.
The Matterhorn bobsled consists of two sides, side A and side B. Side A is on the left and it is longer. My hat! Side B is on the right and it's faster. It's obvious side A is better.
No, it's B.
It's